Today we have Dr. Saundra McGuire, the Assistant Vice Chancellor for Learning, Teaching, and Retention at LSU. In this session, she'll be discussing the study cycle. Thanks for being here again.
Thank you.
Now, I know the study cycle is a process, but can you elaborate on that? What is it exactly?
Absolutely. It's a great process for organizing your study time because so many students come and say, well, I really don't know how to study. So this gives them actually a framework to study. And it's actually derived from a process that was developed by Dr. Frank Crist in California years ago, and we've adapted it to the needs of our students here.
And I know that there are 5 steps, right?
Yes, we've identified 5 steps, and those are previewing the information before lecture, then going to class, then reviewing as soon after class as possible, and then doing some intense study sessions, and then actually assessing your study strategies to see if there's something that you need to tweak to make it even more effective.
Well, I want to talk about all 5 of these in more detail. So let's start with previewing.
Sure. Yes, previewing, we know from the cognitive science literature that if the brain has a big picture of what it's about to learn, and then it gets the individual details, it's much more efficient at learning. It's more efficient than it would be if it just got the individual details and tried to create its own big picture. So the previewing, which takes only about 10 minutes to do, is designed to give your brain that big picture of what's going to be covered in lecture. So it involves looking at the boldface print, any italicized words, charts and graphs to give your brain that overview before lecture.
And just out of curiosity, how much in advance should students preview?
Good question. We say you can do it the day before, the night before, or even the morning of class or 10 minutes before class if you can get to class early. But not prior to about the day or the night before is most helpful.
Okay. And with class, second step is to attend.
Absolutely. Because even though you've done the previewing to give your brain that big picture, it needs the details. And this is what you're going to get when you go to lecture.
With technology these days, though, I mean, you can have some classes offer this, where you can see a video feed of the lecture or audio feed of the lecture once it's completed. So should students really go to class?
You know, a lot of students ask that, and some of them even say, well, I can get the notes from my friends. But we say you absolutely need to go to lecture because being there in the moment, hearing the professor deliver the information, interacting with folks in the class is much more effective than looking at it on a videotape or listening to an audio.
Okay, and step 3 is reviewing. Elaborate on that.
Absolutely. The situation with the brain is if we hear something, it goes into short-term memory. And if you don't do something to move it from short-term memory into long-term memory, that information is going to be lost to you. That's why we can hear a lecture, let's say, on a Sunday. Then Thursday, if somebody asks us exactly what did they say, we can't really remember what they said because it went into short-term memory and we didn't move it into long-term memory. So that review is designed to move that information in. And so what we recommend is as soon after class as possible, look over the lecture notes and your mind then can fill in any gaps that you might have had because you can still have the lecturer's voice fresh in your head at that point.
Right. Well, and for the students who have classes back to back and you know, you're exhausted at the end of the day, how can you effectively review?
Very good question. Yes, we tell those students who say, well, I go to class straight through from 8 o'clock in the morning until 5 o'clock. We say as soon as you can, and it may be at the end of the day. And in that case, you might spend just 5 minutes on each class. But the goal is to go over what was covered in every lecture as soon as you can afterwards.
Well, and step 4 is what many people do. It's study.
Absolutely. And we've actually divided that into steps itself. And that's when you're going to spend that hour's worth of time or 70 minutes really going into depth, doing the reading, maybe coming up with concept maps, working on problems. And so we recommend that students spend a couple of minutes deciding on the goals for that hour and then study intensely, turn off the cell phone, turn off Facebook, study with no distractions, and then review what they've covered in that hour, then go and take a break, and if they have time, come back and do another one.
And you've said to study for an hour. You know, I hear some students, they say, I study 4 hours at a time, you know. So you disagree with that?
Yes. What the research shows is that the brain actually does become fatigued. And so if you're studying at 2-hour stretch without having any breaks at all, you might not recognize that your brain is not really efficiently taking in the information, but it's not. So we recommend that students, after about 60 minutes, 70 minutes max, they take a break, go get some water, take a short walk, and then come back and resume, and then their mind has a chance to be refreshed. Now, let me just say the other end of that. I've had students say, well, I have ADD, so I can't study for an hour. I can't study for 30 right. minutes. And we say, that's fine too. Even if you do 20 minutes where you set a goal for the first couple of minutes, study for 15 minutes, you're going to get a lot out of that session. You may have to do more of those because you're spending less time, but it's fine to do that.
Okay, yeah, that makes sense. Now, the last step, step 5, is to assess.
Absolutely, because you might find that you were spending a lot of time doing concept mapping, but that wasn't the most efficient way for you to learn the information. You might need to spend more time with the reading. So we want you to assess whether or not the strategies that you were using were the most effective ones, and then tweak some things to get even a greater impact.
Okay. Thank you so much for coming in.
Oh, thank you.
For more information on the study cycle and other resources, please visit our website.